We're going to look at various parts of microlab safety. And there are many rules and regulations that we really need to catch up on. First off, as far as clothing goes, no open-toed shoes. This is a microlab. You wouldn't believe what's on the floor here. We want you to wear lab coats, not scrubs. Lab coats can be laundered between labs and you won't think about sitting on your couch in them. We ask you not to wear shorts or expensive clothes to the lab. The reason is it's a micro lab. We will use things that will stain clothing. And if you've got shorts, you're sitting on a chair that we don't know what's on it. We ask that you use safety goggles, especially if you wear contact lenses. We can provide them. However, they are cheap enough that you're probably better off getting your own. And we have gloves for anyone who chooses to use them. Microorganisms we use are not pathogenic. However, that doesn't mean you don't want to be safe. When we think about it, no eating, drinking, applying cosmetics in the lab. There's a simple reason for this. It's a micro lab. Okay? And also, turn off the Bunsen burner when not in use. This is because we don't want to set anybody on fire. With the other safety regulations, report any spill or injury, no matter how small, to the instructor immediately. The reason is we know how to clean these things up, and normally we can do a fairly good job of it, and we want to contain these things very quickly. Security must be called for all emergencies. This includes things as simple as a paper cut. This protects you and allows for medical treatment if necessary. Remember, this is a micro lab, and we are using organisms that, if you break the skin, might be problematic. They could give you some sort of infection. And MSDS sheets, which are manufacturer safety data sheets, are available to anybody upon request. Looking at the front of the room, we can observe all sorts of safety equipment. Next is the fire extinguisher. Point at the base of the fire, pull the pin, and squeeze the trigger. Then we have the first aid kit. Remember, if you get injured, I am going to call security. We are not medical staff, and hopefully someone who is an EMT or nurse will be able to apply first aid. Next, we have the eye wash. It is not a water fountain. If you spill something in your eyes, this will help cleanse the eye. Then we have the chemical shower. Should you spill something all over, this shower is used to dilute the material. This part of the room contains the emergency electrical cutoff valve in case of an electrical emergency. Next is the box with several valves. The blue one is the emergency gas cutoff. Cutoff is when the lever is perpendicular to the pipe. Parallel to the pipe indicates the gas is on. The big white box in the front of the classroom is for broken glass only, nothing else. Do not throw broken glass anywhere else, only in the white box. The back of the lab has aprons if you would like one. Also, the white cabinet has goggles that can be used by anyone. Goggles are recommended for people who wear contacts. They can be acquired for minimal cost at many hardware stores. In the back of the room, there are several containers. The small red box is for sharps. We do not use many for this class. The trash can marked biohazard is for things that have been in contact with biological materials, such as cultures and swabs and loops. This is not for paper towels. The small white buckets are used for microscope slides. After you observe the slides that you made, this is not for prepared slides. Now, upon entering the lab, there are several things you want to do. First, it says place all extra material, including turned off electronics, in the designated area. That's in the front of the classroom. We don't want you taking this stuff all over the classroom. Your lab books, pens, pencils should be the only objects at the lab bench. Remember, you will be working with microorganisms, which means anything you take with you has the possibility of being contaminated. Disinfect the bench top with the detergent solution that we have there, and that is to make sure that it's cleaned from the last time there was a lab. And wash your hands thoroughly. This is anytime you enter. Before you leave the lab, dispose of all refuse in the proper container. Clear the bench and sink areas. Push the stools back in under the table. And this is so that you don't create a trip hazard for anyone else. Disinfect the bench top and then wash your hands thoroughly. So anytime you enter or anytime you're going to leave, you need to wash your hands. And this is to cut down on contamination from everywhere. When we look at biological hazard waste, we will be dealing with biohazard waste. This includes culture plates, gloves, swabs, and any item that came in contact with biological material, however, not glassware and not paper towels. Used slides, we said, go in the small white bucket. Broken glass goes in the big paper box. Other material goes in the trash can, and that includes paper towels from hand washing, sterile wrappers, parafilms. You do not put the gloves in the trash can. Cultures. We're going to ask you to treat everything as pathogenic. Everything we're going to use in this class is not supposed to be hazardous to anybody in the class. However, if you are immunocompromised, if you have a cut, if you have something like that, it could affect and allow something that normally isn't pathogenic to give you some sort of infection, localized infection or something like that. Therefore, you want to be very careful and treat everything as pathogenic. We're going to practice aseptic technique, which is not difficult. And basically that means we're going to try and cut down on contamination. Now, we're going to reiterate, do everything safely and you should have an excellent time in Microlab. And we want you to be as safe as possible.